which the European Union are forcing on us, the types of
Yeah,
chemicals.
well, Americans are mostly forcing it, you know, the American companies, but with gene-modified food and things like that, and we do not know, and nobody knows what's going to happen, because they experiment on long range, and we don't know what happens in a year or 20 years. Just like we don't know what happens, except we start knowing now, what happens with mobile phones in 20 years. You know, they cause brain tumors and blindness and deafness and cancer and whatever. It's totally, totally known. But it's experimentation on the long range.
Do you think that those frequencies and those devices are specifically selected to test on us? Do you think they're changing the species or trying to kill us or change us or whatever?
Well, at least they're making us very sick. And since the goal that I have read of the elite, if I can use that word, is to diminish our population on planet Earth by at least two-thirds, maybe even 5 billion, so that's very, very negative.
Can you explore that more? I mean, we're facing this new disease which is coming out, the swine flu.
Oh, that's just rubbish. Rubbish. You know, it's not the swine flu that's dangerous, it's the injections. Because it's supposedly, it's not only swine, but it is human virus mixed with swine virus, mixed with bird virus. And of course, behind the whole thing is to diminish world population, because it's very toxic, and to get milliards and milliards and milliards into the pockets of those who put them out. Rumsfeld is an owner also in one of the big drug companies. And since they want to diminish the population, so they start saying that children and pregnant women are the first ones, eliminate the next generation.
So you've been trying to alert certain governments about this?
Not governments, but I have written information to Finland, because I don't think it's going to work. Because even if WHO...
It has been tried before in the late 70s?
Yes, 76 they had in the States the swine flu, and it was stopped, the injections, after 3 weeks, because so many people died or got Guillain-Barré syndrome, which is their neurology was destroyed. So now they're making a little adjustment and doing it the same. And before that, they have also made sure in the States that people don't get compensation for the damage in their health, because previously, 76, they had to pay big amounts, like, you know, in the States their compensation is big when you destroy somebody's health. But now they have a law in the States that these companies are not liable, nothing in compensation, if the patient is killed or if the patient is sick for life. So they have really thought about it.
So they can poison us and kill us and get away with it scot-free.
That's right.
So how is this happening? How are so many governments allowing this to just happen?
Because they're not allowing it yet, because nobody has done anything yet. They are just having a scary program in the mass media. All mass media says, oh, it's going to be terrible. Now it's something, bang, bang, bang. It's a scary, scary, scary propaganda. And people get scared because they don't know. Now, WHO has ordered that, you know, everybody has to be by force injected. Previously, WHO did not have this ability to tell them to force any government, because it was only recommendations. But it was 97, 98, I recall, that they signed with 194, was it, states about that if there is a pandemic, or, you know, real serious pandemic, so then they give an order. Now, in the beginning already, in the beginning of June, WHO said pandemic 6, that's the highest. Now, go to any country in the world, people are not sick. There are not millions in swine influenza. So this was just done to force people and prepare the governments to give injections by force. But it's not going to work. I don't think Norway is
going
to do it.
So do you think the figures released by the World Health Organization are actually false?
Of course they are. Of course. Of course. But you have to remember, why do they do this? Always remember, who benefits? Who benefits? They have been forced, in my mind, to do this. And by whom? Big Pharma. Big Pharma which is, you know, deals with the world population and the world money and all this. It's millions.
So what's the ultimate strategy, do you think, that's happening with this? What's their target? What's their intent?
The target is to get rid of so many people as possible and to get as much money for them as possible. But I think they have calculated wrong this time, because already in the Bilderberger meeting, the 14th and 15th of May this year, 1909, in Hellas, there was almost a split when they were discussing this. And I can well imagine that people normally, you know, attending do not always agree with Mr. Kissinger's plan to eliminate a great deal of world population. And now, for instance, yesterday, the Finnish government made a decision, changed laws, which is very interesting, changed laws that swine influenza is not anymore on the list of being a dangerous, serious, contaminating disease. And that means that, of course, then people have to pay for themselves. It's a money question, too. But in my mind, of course, this is a legal question for the lawyers. But in my mind, if something is not a dangerous, contaminatious disease, you cannot be forced to take an injection, right? So I think they were very, very smart. Also, I just read that from the Folk Institute of Health in Norway, that director had said that there has never been many meaning to force people to take, but they can take an injection, and I hope nobody does, especially not children, especially not pregnant women, and actually nobody.